مولاي صل وسلم دائما ابدا. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. One of the Sahabas that we should all have knowledge about is Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu was a Sahaba who people looked down upon because of his physical looks, because of his height. His height was like a dwarf. And because his lineage was not known, people never really respected him. So once the Prophet ﷺ and Julaybib were together, and the Prophet ﷺ asked Julaybib, "What do you want? What do you desire?" And Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu told the Prophet ﷺ that "I only want to serve you. I only desire you." But then the Prophet ﷺ asked, "Don't you want to get married?" Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu said that, "Yes, I would like to get married." So the Prophet ﷺ decided to take the matters into his own hands, and he went and he knocked on somebody's door, and the father of the family answered the door. And the father of the family opened the door, and the Prophet ﷺ said, "I've come for a marriage proposal." The father of the family became very happy and said, "What more do we want? The Messenger of Allah marrying our daughter." But then the Prophet ﷺ said, "This is not for me. This is for Julaybib." And when the mother of the family found out, she said that, no, my daughter is not going to marry Julaybib. Remember, everybody looked down upon Julaybib. Everybody laughed at Julaybib. But subhanAllah, when the daughter of the family found out about the request and proposal of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, the daughter said that if this is the request and proposal of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, then by Allah, I accept this proposal and request. So look at the adab and love the daughter of the family had for the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So Julaybib and the daughter of the family, they get married, the nikah happens, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam does dua, what a blessed marriage, subhanAllah. And later on, an expedition takes place, a military expedition takes place, and after the battle is completed, on the battlefield, when Sahabas are trying to find each other, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he asks, where's Julaybib? So they search for Julaybib and they find his blessed body laying there. Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu had passed away in the battlefield. And in the hadith in Sahih Muslim, it mentions this, فَوَقَفَ عَلَيْهِ, then the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam stood, by him, فَقَالَ, and the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam then said, قَتَلَ سَبَعَةً ثُمَّ قَتَلُوهُ, that Julaybib had killed 7 people, then the enemy had killed him. Yani, by the body of Julaybib, there were seven enemies, and the Prophet ﷺ said that he had killed 7 of them, and then one of the enemy killed him. And then the Prophet ﷺ said in a very, very sad tone that "Hada minni wa ana minhu," and he repeated this 2 or 3 times, "Hada minni wa ana minhu." This man, i.e. Julaybib, this man is of me and I am of him. This man is of me and I am of him. And Allahu Akbar, look at the blessed death of Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, he picks up Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu and he places him in the grave. This was the story of Julaybib radiallahu ta'ala anhu. In society, people look down upon him because of his lineage, because of his physical looks. But in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the eyes of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he had great maqam, he had great status. And this is a lesson we all need to learn. Sometimes people, they're different to us. Maybe they're from a different background, a different caste, a different language, a different country, a different culture. Sometimes people, they might even, for example, in particular cases, might even look a bit funny.
might look a bit odd. And in these sort of cases, never ever, never look down upon anybody, never make fun of anybody, never be racist, never, you know, be rude to anybody, because in the end, you don't know who is beloved to Allah. You don't know who is close to Allah. My dear brothers, when you go around shaking hands with other Muslim brothers, always think to your heart that this Muslim brother I am shaking hands with, maybe he is more pious than me, and maybe he is a beloved servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a lesson we all need to take from this. Look at the maqam of Julaybib. Look at how much love he had for the Rasul, and look how much love the Rasul had for him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is the love we need to develop as well. And we do dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps us all humble. We do dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps us all pious. Allah ta'ala makes us into people who pray 5 times a day, fast for his sake, and do hajj for his sake. I do dua that Allah ta'ala grants us the true love of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. وَمَا عَلَيْنَا إِلَّا الْبَلَاغُ